likes cookies? If you do, then you're in luck, because today we're exploring the chemistry of cookies. My name is Caitlin, and I'm an educator at the Ontario Science Centre. But today I'm filming from my kitchen. That's so we can safely explore the delicious science of cookies. Safety notes. First, make sure you have permission from a parent, guardian, or responsible adult to be using the oven in your kitchen. Don't leave the oven unattended when you're baking. Second, make sure you also have the permission to use groceries. Finally, you're not allowed to eat or drink in science class. We have the same rule at the Ontario Science Centre. Today is an exception because we're working in the safety of our own kitchen using reagents, aka ingredients, purchased at the grocery store. For me, the best cookie is light, chewy, and perfectly browned. In your opinion, what makes the best cookie? And what ingredients do you think will help achieve those qualities? Ingredients are the building blocks of cookies, just like atoms are the building blocks of matter. What causes your cookies to rise? Why do they turn brown? And how do you get that chewy texture? Let's investigate. I have a confession to make. I can't remember which of these two bowls has my flour in it. Okay, so density to the rescue. I know that I measured out my cornstarch and my flour. So each one of these bowls has to contain one of those ingredients. I also know that cornstarch and flour have different densities. I'll add a spoonful of each one to the glass of water in front and hopefully be able to figure out the difference. Which one do you think will sink? Which one do you think will float? Do you think they'll both sink? Do you think they'll both float? Why do you think that? So, which one do you think is which? Now I can go ahead and make my cookies. So I was able to figure out the difference between the flour and the cornstarch using their physical properties. But if you mix up some other ingredients, you can use their chemical properties to differentiate them. Take, for example, two leaveners, baking soda and baking powder. Do you think that you could use reaction with acid to figure out a difference? Why or why not? Okay, so they both reacted with acid because they both contain a base. But what about water? Will they both react with water? Only the baking powder fizzed with water due to the acid inside its formula. When water was added to that container, both the acid and the base dissolved, allowing them to react, producing a gas. Both baking powder and baking soda fizz. That's why they're so good at making cookies light and fluffy. But what about yeast? Could you use yeast to make your cookies? I'm going to test yeast with some sugar for food and warm water, baking powder with some water, and baking soda with some vinegar. Predict what you think will happen right now. How big those balloons got from the yeast with water, the baking powder with water, and the baking soda with vinegar. What do you think would make the best cookie? A lot of gas produced or just a little bit? Whichever one you decide, test it out in your recipe. The chemical and physical properties of your cookie dough are going to depend on the chemical and physical properties of your ingredients. Some questions you might want to ask yourself are, what are the texture or solubility of your ingredients? If you're using something like coconut oil or butter, what's its melting point? Do you want to use that ingredient in its liquid state or its solid state? And finally, as you're mixing your dough, will your ingredients react with each other? Will they react with water? Now let's think about as your cookies bake. When you put that dough in the oven, it's going to start to heat up. At around 32 to 35 degrees Celsius, the butter, assuming you use butter, is going to start to melt. Your cookie dough is going to start to spread out on your baking sheet. It's turning more liquid. The edges of your cookie will thin. These thin cookie edges are exposed to proportionally more heat inside the oven. That's heat coming down from the top and the sides in the oven, as well as heat being conducted through your cookie sheet up on the bottom. Because these edges are thinner, they're going to start to set up and solidify before the rest of your cookie bakes. Let's consider the rest of that cookie that's still in that liquidy state. It's going to start to rise. As the butter inside your cookie melts, water is released. Baking soda in your dough is then going to dissolve inside that water and can react with acid coming from dairy products or brown sugar inside your dough. This acid-base reaction is going to cause gas to be released, which is going to rise your dough up, giving that nice airy texture inside. But how does that structure set? Why do you keep that even after the cookie is taken out of the oven? That's thanks to the egg protein and starches inside your cookie dough. Around 60 degrees Celsius, proteins from egg and starch start to solidify, which is going to help with your final cookie structure. Your oven is set higher than 60 degrees Celsius. So as the temperature of your cookie increases up to 170 degrees Celsius, the sugar in your cookie dough is going to start to melt, turning into a liquid. There's going to be a pyrolytic reaction of that sugar inside the dough. That means it's going to break down, it's going to decompose due to heat and turn into caramel. That gives you that really nice nutty toffee taste. Finally, after you've taken your baked cookies out of the oven and let them cool down on the counter, the liquid sugar in your dough is going to start to set. The air inside your cookies is going to start to cool down and the cookie's going to deflate. It's going to contract a little bit. That's why you need that structure from the eggs and the flour to help your cookie keep its shape. Now that you're a cookie expert, I'm going to challenge you to make your perfect cookie. Take the recipe that we've posted online and change some of the variables. Maybe think about the ingredients, their physical properties, their chemical properties, and how you make the cookie. Here are a couple of examples that different educators from the Ontario Science Centre have made. Once you've found your perfect cookie, we invite you to share your recipe with us. Post the recipe or a picture of your cookies on our social media page. Thanks for watching. Bye.